Don't you hate it when you get instructions sometimes and they make absolutely no sense and the tools they want you to use don't even exist? I guess you get what you pay for. And trust me, for this roof rack that I wanted to put on my car, I paid the least amount that I could possibly find. It comes to a total about $138, and for that $138, you get a pretty decent rack. It holds about 75 kilos, or 165 pounds, and they're very good about making sure that they size it up and tell you how wide of a car it's going to fit, so I'm pretty happy with that. Now, most of these other systems are over $400, so when I'm spending only $138, I am expecting some headaches and definitely not the best quality craftsmanship or materials. So the actual selecting and buying experience was fine. The installation, however, was a different story. So this is everything that came in the box. First, the two cross members. Secondly, the instructions. The instructions you really can't use completely. Again, I'll get into that in a little bit. The third thing were the actual feet and the mechanisms to ratchet. That's the silver items there. So you have four pairs. And then the keys and, you know, these plates, which actually in the picture of the instructions show them installed. Here they come uninstalled. And there's two styles of hooks that attach to the side of the door frame, depending on your car. Now, the instructions were completely wrong. Now, the picture in the instruction shows the foot connected to the crossbeam. However, in my case, everything is completely disassembled, and there were no instructions on how to actually assemble it together. So, I had to use some logic. If it came as was in the picture, then no problem. But because it came completely disassembled, I had to make that part up. So the first thing I do is put that little metal strip into the plastic protective boot. And I brought the anchor that goes around the door frame to my car just to check which one is going to fit. Took me a little while to try to squeeze this in here, but you're supposed to put it a little bit in and on an angle, and then gotta really have to kind of push it through for some of them. But when you're done, it should rest flush. Like that. And then the protective boot, which also protects the car's paint, just goes over there. Now, this is the part where there are absolutely no instructions, and the position of the foot. In the instructions, it says turn it halfway around because it's installed a certain way. So I just put it in that way, and that metal piece is like a backing for that nut. I had to use a pair of scissors to kind of make sure the bolt was poking up enough so I could secure the nut in. And because there was no plastic tool, I used my own little ratchet. No problem. Then, put the boot back on. And voila, as in the picture, but with a ton of hassle. Now, the most interesting part was the key. I was like, this key's not going in. And it only went in when I put a significant amount of pressure on it to pop it in. Now, once you screw it open, this pops up. And this actual piece is actually the ratcheting mechanism in order to tighten the rack onto the roof. And I had a lot of trouble also trying to get that key to be removed. So once I put it in, I couldn't remove the key. It ends up turning that barrel for the lock has to be in a certain orientation in order for it to release and turn and lock in place. So I had to play around with that quite a bit. And how this works is you stick that in and you can see those little notches in that metal. And when you open up the device, once you can finally get a key in, what you're going to do here is you're going to ratchet it, and it should pull in that bracket, which also tightens it against the door frame. If you need to remove it, you have to lift up this black lever, and then it should pop out. When it's really tight, It doesn't pop out that easily, which I found when I'm trying to reposition the rack. So you got to be careful there. But it will pop out eventually with some wiggling and shimmying and jimmying. Now I made sure I cleaned the areas where the feet are going to go so I don't scratch the paint. And then I work on ratcheting one side. Obviously not too tight because the other side isn't attached. So I go to the other side, make sure I tighten it up. And this side I had such a hard time to try to get that key inside. Finally, it actually turned without the key even going in all the way. So, not a really good design. So once I ratchet that nice and tight, I can ratchet the other side nice and tight, make sure everything is secure, giving it the old trusty wiggle to make sure I got everything working okay. So in conclusion, you do get what you pay for. The craftsmanship, not great. The instructions, not good. But once everything's together, the actual fit is pretty good. I'm really happy with them. They feel really sturdy and I feel pretty secure when I put my brand new paddleboard on the rack. And of course, a review of that paddleboard will be coming as to why, well, I used to be more of a canoer, why I switched over to a paddleboard. So would I buy this again? Yes. For the money, it is worth it for what I'm going to be using it for. I may be putting like a luggage cargo carrier on top. So for me, it's definitely worth the headache of trying to put that thing together. Feels pretty sturdy, and I don't think it's going to be coming off. Almost forgot the joke of the day. Have you heard the rumor going around about butter? Never mind. I shouldn't spread it. So coming up will be a new video about my paddleboard. And I'm telling you, on beautiful nights like this, nothing beats it. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next Ladybug Adventure.